just consider how bizarre it would look if you peeled away the fuselage of an airliner with X-ray vision mid-flight, 10,000 feet above ground, witnessing the mundane activities of the passengers soaring like lackluster cherubim through the clouds, eating snacks, complaining about the in-flight entertainment and lack of leg space. Aviation is an aberration, a miracle reduced to a tedious inconvenience. Does anyone even look at the clouds and wonder anymore? Nah. Instead, we rewatch a blockbuster we did not enjoy all that much the first time either. Midway, Into Seabiscuit, the true story of the undersized Depression-era racehorse, whose victories lifted not only the spirits of the team behind it, but also their nation. I noticed an unexpected sensation. My throat suddenly filled with cotton. A shortness of breath ensued. Finally, I lost it and started to cry. Apparently, the phenomenon of heightened emotions on airplanes is widespread. Some say it's due to high altitude and cabin pressure, which reduces oxygen in the cabin. I did not know that then. Instead, I surmised that I was having a mental breakdown. For the landing. Caught off guard by this foreign custom, I started to fidget with the in-flight radio channels. A creeping feeling of being part of an elaborate prank manifested itself as one of the few songs that not under any conditions should be played on an airplane radio channel was inexplicably played on said airplane radio channel. As I scanned the cabin to see if anyone else was also hearing John Denver singing about leaving on an airplane, unsure of when he would return, a sudden urge to scream, "Is anyone else hearing this?" was pushed back. Instead, I listened intently to the song and realized that the moment was, in a sense, perfect. A few months later, during Carnival, I received a call from my mother informing me that Grandma had passed. I decided not to return home to her funeral. I did this with my mother's blessing, but in hindsight, I can't believe my selfishness. The worst thing is, I think I made the right decision. Returning home up north prematurely from the sandy beaches and tropical rains of Brazil seemed, in a word, insane. I decided to let the Atlantic Ocean wash away my guilt. Sadly, I only cry on airplanes.